Right, in this video, what we'd like to show you is how to calculate the heat losses for a small building. This is a model of a small village hall, and inside you can see you've got a large hall here and some kitchen accommodation to one side. What I'd like to show you is how to calculate the actual heat losses through the hall section, this part here, so that you can determine how many radiators and what the output of those radiators are to heat the room to say a temperature of about 20 degrees. Now, I prepared the actual heat loss calculation on this chart here, which will be quite easy to go through and explain to you how this works. As the table has been drawn up here, and there's the surface that we're going to consider, the wall surface or the windows, the area, its U value, and what the thermal loss will be through that particular part of the structure. Now, as I mentioned before in one of our other videos, if you're not sure what a U value is, there's another video which deals with that subject, and I suggest that you can look at that next so you fully understand how you calculate the U value for a particular material. So let's just look at the particular aspects of this particular hall here. First of all, we look at the floor. We take the floor area, and in this case this is 104 square meters. The U value of the heat which is transmitting down, the structure going through there, is 0.6. You multiply those two figures together and that gives you a thermal loss of 62.4 watts per Kelvin. Now, the walls, these external walls around here and this wall section at the end here, add up to 102 square meters, and that would have a U value of about 0.4, depending of course on the insulation of the walls, and that comes out again if you look at our video on calculation of U values, and that gives you a thermal loss of 40.8. The windows in this case would be double glazed windows, have a total area of 16 square meters, and they would have a U value of 2, giving you a total loss of 32. The roof, this whole area up here, less of course the actual window areas because we take that separately, has an area of 146 square meters and has a heat and has a U value of 0.35, giving you a loss of 51. The windows, 9.6, a U value slightly different on those, 2.2, giving you a loss of 21. Now, one other factor that you may have to consider, but we don't need to consider it in this example, are the internal walls. And unless there's a temperature difference between that room and that room there, you don't need to bother about calculating that in. It was only if that area wasn't heated would you take some loss factor into consideration there. So for this example, we haven't taken the internal walls. Add the total thermal loss up, and in this example it comes to 207.3. Now I show you how we convert that into the actual heating requirements. So we assume that the room temperature required is 20 degrees C and the outside temperature is zero. That's typical winter conditions. So our heat loss will go a delta T, a difference in temperature, of 20 degrees. That's 0 taken away from 20 gives you 20 degree difference in loss. So the heat loss for the fabric is the thermal loss here times the temperature difference, which will give you 4,146 watts. That's the heat loss through the pure fabric. Now, in a room like this, and as in any other room, you have what's called air infiltration. That means where the air starts to leak out through the structure, through cracks around the glazing systems, or people leaving doors open. And the air infiltration is calculated by the volume of air that you're going to lose times the specific heat of that air, and again times the temperature difference. In this example, the volume of this hall is 520 square meters, and the factor, the specific heat factor, is 0.33 times by 20 degrees difference in temperature, gives you a heat loss on the air infiltration of 3,432 watts. Add those two together and that will give you the total heat loss requirements for that particular hall as 7,578 watts. Now, to convert that into the radiators that you want, suggest on a hall of that size you probably need about 6 radiators. So we can just do the final calculation on the radiator sizing. Hopefully you can see that. And you divide 6 into the figure of 7,578, and that will result in each radiator, it's got to give you 1,263 watts of heating output. If you take your radiator sizing catalogue from a typical manufacturer, and you can get information on manufacturers that will do radiators for you on our main site, which is dealsforhomes.co.uk. And just taking this example here in this book here, there's a radiator here which has got a height of 600 millimetres, it's got a length of 1 metre long, and it has an output of 1336 watts. So that will be more than adequate for what we're looking for. So it's 600 millimetres high by 1000 millimetres long, and that gives you 1336 watts. That meets that requirement there. So that's basically how you work out the heating requirements and the radiator sizing for that type of building. So it's 6 radiators there, each given 1.3 kilowatts each. Hope you found that useful. Obviously then, if you want to work out the whole of the building, you use the same approach to each room and then collectively adding that up, and that's eventually how you work out your overall boiler size.